Delhi Public School Patna was committed for this green school project, and from the very beginning, like I'll tell you, when this building was made in 2002, at that time itself the school management had thought about rainwater harvesting, and the way the building was made, even the architect, we were more focused on how to reuse water.
DPS Patna has a rainwater harvesting system that captures 70% of the rain that falls on its campus. This is used in the swimming pool and for gardening.
A part of the rainfall, whatever we are getting, that is collected on the rooftop collection tank, which is led to the toilets of the building. And the other rooftops, which are not connected directly to the collection tank, through the rainwater pipes, they are connected to 25 underground chambers.
From the rooftop, the rainwater comes, then it goes through these pipes, and then these pipes are inside these pillars. Then these pipes go down, and from this, these join into the underground chambers. And then with these, there are various chambers along this line. Then these chambers meet with the main chamber that is present there. The surplus rainwater that was collected from those outside chambers comes to this main chamber, and in this it is then pumped into this filtration tank. Here it is loaded with alum so that these sediments settle down. If it is the monsoon season, then it goes to the swimming pool after chlorination. And there are other pipes as well where the water goes to the grass field, so that the water is given to the grass and also to the botanical garden.
Secondly, this water can also be used whenever we have some breakout of fire or something like that, because firefighting device completely it is connected to this tank.
And there is another system, some surplus rainwater is there from the paved area through the slope. It goes to the recharge trenches.
They have an inverted filtration system which has layers of pebbles and sand. And then the water from here is sent for recharge to the aquifers. These are 250 feet long, 1.5 feet wide and 10 to 15 feet deep.
And we have measured the groundwater of this surrounding aquifer, and there is a subsequent increase in the level of the groundwater.
Waste is managed with source segregation and vermicomposting.
We had only one bin in the classroom, and at the end of the day it was a tough task for housekeeping staff to segregate all these waste and to put them in the different drums. So last year we got a suggestion based on our audit with CSE. It was suggested that if we teach our children to segregate the waste at source, then we thought about, and now this year we have introduced two bins in the classroom only.
Last year onwards, we have developed the method of composting the organic waste in our school premises itself. We have created a vermicomposting pit here, which helps us to dump the organic waste.
While doing an analytical data, we actually saw that the produce of manure has been doubled from last year. So it is an immense achievement for us.
About 100 kgs of compost is generated every month, which is used for gardening.
It helps us to provide the organic fertilizer in a natural way to all the school garden, as well as whatever other area we would like to cultivate.
And then plastic waste that I told you that hardly we generate, but however, whatever is there, that we sell it to the kabariwalas. Sanitary waste, we do not have any solution till now, we are thinking upon, but that are sent to the landfill.
The school recycles about 60% of its waste and gives its e-waste to an authorized dealer.
We generate around 2 quintal paper waste every month. On Wednesday, we have different club activities, and paper recycling club is one of them. There are many students enrolled in that club. So they work here and they use all the old answer sheets and whatever paper waste.
In the year 2017, the school has completely moved to a sustainable mode of transportation.
In the air audit, this year we calculated the number of buses, and we saw our school has 55 buses in total. This year, we also saw an interesting fact that 100% of students are opting for buses from their stops.
I shifted from car to school bus last year, and that is because we are being taught about sustainable development. Like, that is using the resources so that the future generation, they can also use that well.
The school has a good food program. where packaged food inside the campus is not allowed. All children bring homemade food and teachers monitor what they eat.
We have a predefined food menu by which children are supposed to bring the homemade food which is good for the health and their overall development.
The school uses energy-efficient LED and CFL lighting systems.
We went classroom by classroom surveying the different number of appliances in each class as well as the different halls in the school. And we found out that all the lightings were normally tube lights. So we have requested the school administration to phase out the tube lights and install CFLs or LEDs in the place of the tube lights.
We are very much concerned about energy conservation. If you see our classrooms, they are well ventilated and even sufficient amount of sunlight comes in the daytime. So we hardly require lights in the daytime.
As a part of this audit, I got to know more about the energy consumption and how to save electricity and save energy.
In the next year, we also have a proposal to put up solar panels on our terrace, which is a very big area. Half of the area is being used for terrace farming, and rest half we'll be definitely placing or going with solar panels. Because the school only works for 7 to 1, so 6 hours. So even if these 6 hours, if you are using the renewable sources of energy rather than using the electricity coming from mains, we hope we'll be able to make our children aware of renewable sources of energy.